Venom's not here today, man. Welcome, boils and ghouls, to the Carnage Vlog.
Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome back to the Summer of Carnage right here on the Venom Vlog. And today we have an interview from Collider Video. So big shout out to Collider and their website and Adam Cheatwood, who is the person who did the interview with Robert Richardson, the cinematographer. I talked about him like not even a week or week and a half ago about him joining as cinematographer for this movie. And he said some pretty interesting things. Some things that, you know, obviously like the clickbait titles will go out there and be like, oh, he confirmed this actor's returning, which is great. But I felt like we mostly knew that. But it is good always to get the confirmation. So it seems like he's confirming that a certain actor will come back. So we'll talk about that in a minute. But what I find interesting is the behind the scenes stuff he talks about, the look of the film, how he wants to capture things, how he wants to pay tribute to Matty Libatique, who was the cinematographer of the first movie. And I like that. I again, it shows class. Like when fandoms freak out, like, oh, the new person's coming in is going to do better than the old person and blah, blah, blah. I hate that so much because that's not how these people see that at all. They come in and they in most cases will go, I want to look at what was done before. I want to respect that and grow from there. So it feels like what I'm doing fits in the same universe, but then I add my own spin to some of it as well. It's like hearing that is, that's professionalism. That's how professionals act. and it's so great to see this. I mean, of course, this guy's a professional. He's a legend in my mind, you know, with cinematography and film, and worked with some of the greatest out there. You know, Tarantino, Scorsese, just top-notch guy right here. And he's also worked with Andy Serkis before, so he talks a little bit about that. And this article ultimately is about why he joined Venom 2. And he said at one point he was, like years ago, was supposed to be, you know, tied up or connected to doing something with Ben Affleck and Batman. So I'm guessing that's Ben Affleck's Batman movie, solo Batman movie, that was supposed to come out after Justice League. I'm going to assume that. Maybe, who knows? Maybe he was going to be on Batman v Superman. I have no idea. But I think he's talking about the solo Batman film. And so he talked about, you know, I've never done anything like that. I've always done like all these other movies, like with Scorsese and stuff, and obviously with Tarantino. And I kind of wanted to branch out. And that's the other thing is like people like go, oh, why is this guy doing this? You know, like it seems beneath him or something. It's like, no, he wants to challenge himself. He's been in the business for a while, and he's like, I want to do something new. And that's how actors feel. Like when people go, oh, I hate Fat Thor. It's like, all right, you may hate that, but that's, you know, Chris Hemsworth wanted to do something new. He's been playing the character for like 8 years or 9 years. He wanted to bring something new to the table. That's what happens when you're on a project for a long time. It's like, you know, you want to try something different each time to make it feel new to you and to bring something new to you, and hopefully new to the audience that they like, you know. And sometimes you like it, sometimes you don't. That's what these people are all about. They want to challenge themselves. They want to grow. And it's great to hear it from a guy like this who I think is already at the top of his game, but he still is like, yeah, I want to try something different. So when the Batman thing fell through, he's like, I worked with Andy Serkis on Breathe, and he reached out to me and said, hey, you know, I'm doing this Venom 2 thing. And he says he reached out to him about a month ago. So it was like almost right after, you know, he was, you know, given or announced as the person, or maybe the week before he was announced as the person, and they were like starting to crew up and gear up. And it looks like he was like, you know, hey, would you come and play in this sandbox with us with Venom 2? And luckily for all of us, Robert Richardson said, yes, I will. I'll be there. And he also says, he goes, he's like, you have a remarkable central character with Venom, but now you've got Woody Harrelson, who's going to obviously make his own little entrance here, and we'll see what else comes with the Sony Marvel collaboration. So he's even mentioning that too. I mean, like, this guy is already tapped in. He talked about how he watched the first movie. He's doing his homework. He's learning about who the character is. And this is the guy who's, you know, just, you know, his job is to frame the scene. But this shows how much work goes into stuff. These guys and girls who, and everyone who works on these movies, they do their research. They take it seriously. And whether you like the final product or not, hard work is put into it. And you can sit there and be mad at corporate people and people above for, you know, taking Spider-Man away from the MCU universe or whatever you want to do. But all these people, the people that work on the movies, they're just people who want to do the best job they can. And it's so great to see that and hear him talk about that and him confirm, though, that Woody Harrelson is coming back as Carnage. And then, like he said, he hinted, and who knows what else will come up from the Sony Marvel collaboration. And I think that's him saying, like, you know, now that Spider-Man's available, who knows, maybe we'll get to do a post-credit scene with Spider-Man. Like, I'm not trying to put words in his mouth. I'm just saying, like, I'm just talking about the possibilities of what his comment here means. Could mean another villain. Maybe we'll see not just, Cletus Cassidy in this movie. Maybe there'll be a second villain or something, you know, who knows? So I'm curious, although if it is a second villain, I hope it's Shriek. Because in that way it fits more organically with like a Cletus Cassidy story. So yeah, and then they asked, Adam here, I think that's, yeah, Adam, he asked, about Maddie Lee Batik. He was like, hey, you know, he established in the first movie, what are you going to bring to the sequel? And what I like is his answer here, again, just showing the pure professionalism. He says, you know, that actually hasn't been determined in a lot of ways, but I do think that you have to honor what Maddie did. So again, it's still early in the process. He just got, you know, brought on as a crew member and he's doing his homework and his research right now. He said he just watched the first movie and he watched it a couple times. He goes, so we are going to, use some locations that are already established. He goes, so I want to make sure our movie matches that as far as lighting goes and the look of it goes. He goes, because I don't want this to feel like a departure from the first film. I want you to feel like you're still in the same universe, even though we have a different director and a different cinematographer. I still want to capture at least some of these sets, like, you know, the same way that Maddie did. So he goes, he's like, you can't not do that because that's just, you know, and I love that he said that because it's like some people would, they'd be like, I didn't like the first movie. I'm just going to do my own thing. He's like, no, you have to respect what came before, whether you like it or not. But he's just like, I have to. Maddie's a top tier talent dude. And he goes, and I want to respect what he did. And I'm like, that's amazing. He goes, so any locations that have already been used, I'm going to try to match it the best I can. And that's why I'm watching the movie and studying it. He's like, because I want to capture those locations, to a T. He goes, but there is going to be new locations and new environments that we go to. And for those, I definitely want to bring, you know, like my own style to it. So, and I'm paraphrasing big time, of course, here. But he says they're going to be lit in what I hope is exactly the same way. So you don't feel that there's a disconnect from the film to the, from the last film to this film. And in terms of the rest, that's yet to be discussed because I haven't sat down with Andy yet. He's over in London right now. And I guess he's going to go meet over there and they're going to start getting into visual effects, storyboards, and all that info is coming up for him. So the train is running and he's moving and it looks like they're going to really try to hit that November film date, start filming in November, if not maybe a little sooner, because obviously they're going to want to make sure they have plenty of time to get the movie filmed and all the visual effects done and everything before it comes out next year. And some people are already like, you know, like, how are they going to do this? How are they going to put this movie together in just such a short amount of time? That doesn't seem a lot for visual effects. Well, typically with visual effects, you'll start doing them before the movie even starts filming sometimes, especially when you have a time crunch like this. So what they'll probably do is they'll look at storyboards, they'll look at designs, concept art, and like preliminary visual effects, and at least be placeholder things. They're going to get all the models done, all the hard work and little things that you got to do to prep. They're going to get all that done so that way they can start, fitting that in once the movie starts being filmed and stuff. So it's great to see this well-oiled machine already well-oiled and moving ahead. And that's very exciting for us because that means, you know, throughout the next couple months, we might still get snippets of movie news. And then, as we get into November, you know, I might have to start season 4 early actually in November if we finish, I'm planning to finish season 3 in November. But it sounds like we might have to start season 4 almost immediately because, you know, we're going to start getting videos of people filming in, you know, like home videos of people in Atlanta on their phones, you know, recording stuff that's happening. And we covered a lot of that in the first season of this show when they filmed the first movie. So we're going to get back into that mode coming up pretty soon, in the next few months. And that, to me, is very exciting. I can't wait to see some of the behind the scenes stuff. So, yes, it's going to be a fun time. And I can't wait to share all this information with you as it comes out. And this one I want to share with you guys today. So I'll put a link down below to the Collider article so you can read everything in full and you can send them some love since they, did the hard work of, you know, pinning down Richardson and getting the interview and stuff. And we got the easy job of just reading it to you guys. So I did skip over some parts so that way you guys can have some extra information when you go read it at their site. So thank you so much. Let me know what you think of this down below. Woody Harrelson, obviously confirmed coming back, but then also Richardson paying respect to Maddie Lee Batik and, who we talked very highly about in the first season. And, you know, and I'm excited to hear him say like, no, we're going to honor what he did in the locations that he shot in, but then we're also going to bring new things to the table as well. And that's great to hear. So again, professionalism at its core, and that's what it's all about in the industry, at least with these guys who do respect each other and respect each other's work. So, you know, not the seedy side of it, which we don't really talk about on here at all, because it's just, it would depress all of us. But anyway, here, to end on a high note, go check this article out. It's awesome. And Venom 2 coming next year. I'm so excited. We're almost we're like 14 months away from Venom 2. I mean, just insane, insane. The train never stops around here on the Venom vlog, and I don't plan to sleep anytime soon, so I can cover all of it for you. So thank you so much. In the next episodes, we'll be talking about Absolute Carnage. We got some more tie-ins. I think issue 2 comes out this week as well, and some tie-ins like Lethal Protector and Miles Morales. So we have a lot of stuff to get to. So I will get those comic books tomorrow morning. I'll read them, and I'll try to get some videos up to you guys by Thursday regarding all that. And then I got to go to Halo Outpost Discovery, the Halo Con. So you won't see any Venom stuff over the whole weekend at all, actually. So I'll try to get it all done before I go down to Anaheim. And all you're going to see on the weekend, if you follow my gaming channel, is you'll see Halo Outpost updates. So I'll be posting videos over there throughout the weekend. So thank you guys so much, and we'll see you next week here on the Venom Vlog. We'll see you in the next episode of the Venom Vlog, and then after those Absolute Carnage ones, we'll see you next week. I clearly need some sleep right now, so I'm going to go try to get a little bit of that before work. Thanks so much for watching the show. As always, like, share, subscribe, all that fun stuff, and I'll see you in the future. Peace.